In arranging groups and periods. Okay, this is called as periodic table. Okay, first of all, let us talk about the periodic nature. Periodic nature means any phenomena which repeats in regular intervals. Any phenomena which repeats in regular intervals is called as periodic nature. This is very, very most important. Periodic nature means any phenomena which repeats in regular intervals, any phenomena which repeats in regular intervals are called periodic nature. For example, periods of class hours in our timetable. Okay, periods of class hours in our timetable. And the next one, mathematical example, period of sine curve is 2 pi, and period of tan function is pi. This is for one type of periodic nature. Okay, next one you will study historical classifications. Historical classifications. Historical classifications. The first one, Levo is a classification. Second one, Dabbernere classification. Third one, Newlands classification. Next one, Mendeley's classification. Fourth one, Moseley's classification. Sixth one, modern periodic classification.
order and periodic classification.
Order and periodic classification. Okay. First one, let us talk about Levo is the classification. Levo is a classification. Levo is a classification. He divided known elements into two groups. First of all, he divided known elements into two groups. Their first one, metals. Second one, non-metals. Okay, first one metals, second one non-metals. First one, let us talk about metals. Metal means when the elements which have the tendency to loss of electrons. And elements which have the tendency to loss of electrons are called metals. Okay. When the elements which have the tendency loss of electrons are called metals. For example, sodium metal, magnesium, aluminium, etc. Okay. When the elements which have the tendency to loss of electrons are called metals. Okay. Second one, non-metals. Non-metal means when the elements which have the tendency to gain of electrons are called non-metals. Okay. When the elements which have the tendency to gain of electrons are called non-metals. For example, oxygen, chlorine, bromine, iodine, okay, etc. These are the examples for non-metals. Okay, he divided, once again, Levo is a classification, he divided known elements into two groups. Their first one metals, second one non-metals. Okay. Metal means when the elements which have the tendency to loss of electrons are called as metals. Non-metal means when the elements which have the tendency to gain of electrons are called as non-metals. Okay. Draw diagram. Okay. Completed up. Write down. Drawback. His classification was rejected after the discovery of meteorites. Okay. Drawback. His classification was rejected
after the discovery of meteorites, after the discovery of meteorites, discovery of meteorites. Okay, what are the meteorites? Meteorites. Meteorites means then the elements which exhibits the properties of both metals and non-metals. Such type of elements are called as metalloids. Okay. Then the elements which exhibit the property of both metals and non-metals are called metalloids. Called metalloids. Metalloids. Okay. Example. Arsenic, selenium, germanium, tellurium, polonium. Okay, like that. Okay, arsenic symbol AS. Arsenic symbol AS. Selenium symbol SE. Tellurium symbol TE. Polonium symbol PO. Germanium symbol GE. Okay, these are the exams for metalloids. Right on. Vignesh, Datrina, completed up. Students completed up. Okay, thank you. Next, the next important classification is Dobonnier classification. Dobonnier classification. Dobonnier classification. Dobonnier classification. In Dobonnier classification, first of all, let us talk about triode. Triode means group of three elements. Triode means group of three elements. What is the main important statement of Dobonnier classification? Increasing order of their atomic mass numbers such that. Okay. Increasing order of the atomic mass number such that the atomic mass of the middle element is the approximate average atomic masses of the other two elements. It's called as Dobonnier classification. It's called as Dobonnier classification. Once again, increasing order of their atomic mass numbers such that The atomic mass of the middle element is the approximate average atomic masses of the other two elements is called as Daubonnet classification. Okay, I can write triad. Triad means group of three elements. Group of three elements. Increasing order of the atomic mass number such that the atomic mass of the middle element, the atomic mass of the middle element is the approximate average. is called Daubonnet classification. Daubonnet classification. For example, example one. Now we can take lithium, sodium, potassium. Okay, lithium symbol Li, sodium symbol Na, potassium symbol is K. Lithium mass number is 7, sodium mass number is 23, potassium mass number is 39. How to calculate the average of other two elements? That is equal to lithium atomic mass plus potassium atomic mass by 2. That is equal 7 plus 39, 46 by 2. That is equal to 23. In this value is equal to the middle element of the atomic mass. Okay, this is example one. It is very most important. Now we can take example two. Okay, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Chlorine mass number is 35.5. Bromine mass number is 80. Now we can take iodine mass number is 127. Iodine mass number is 127. Okay. Now we can take chlorine and the iodine mass values. 35.5 plus 127 by 2. That is equal to 162.5 by 2. That is equal to approximately 81.25. This value is approximately equal to bromine atomic mass. These two elements are called as triode. Okay. Now we can take another example. Example 3. Now we can take calcium, strontium, barium. Calcium mass is 40, strontium mass is 88, barium mass is 137. Okay. Barium mass is 137. That is equal to 40 plus 137. By 2, that is equal to 40 plus 137, that is equal to 177. 177 by 2, that is equal to 88.5. This is the approximate value of strontium. These are called Dawarney triodes. Write down. Complicated? Okay. What is the main drawback of Dawarney classification? Drawback of Dawarney classification.
Let's
see.
Next.
You've got to turn my book. I'm very close to the day.
Drawback. He could arrange the limited groups. Okay, limited groups. Okay, next one. Right. Important classification is Newlands classification. Newlands classification. Okay. Newland classification means increasing order of their atomic mass numbers such that every 8th element property is similar to the first element. Okay, every 8th element property is similar to the first element, just like a musical scale. Every 8th note similar to the first note. Every 8th note similar to the first note. This is called as Newland's classification. This is also called as Newland's octave's law. Okay. Increasing order of the atomic mass number such that every 8th element property is similar to the first element, just like a musical scale. Every 8th note similar to the first note. This is called Newland's octave's law. Okay. Increasing order of the increasing order of the atomic mass numbers, atomic mass numbers, mass numbers such that every eighth element properties similar to the first element, similar to the first element, first element, just like a musical scale, just like a musical scale, every eighth note similar to the first note. This is called Newland's octave's law. Newland's octave's law. Okay. Octave's law. Okay. Right on. Completed, huh? So it's completed, huh? Example.
Sa Re Ga Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni. Okay. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. Okay, these are called music notes. Okay, Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. Okay, the first one, now we can take lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine. Next one, sodium, magnesium, aluminium,
silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. After that, potassium, calcium only. Lithium, sodium, potassium exhibits same valences, like that plus one valency. Okay. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, plus two valency. Okay. Every eighth element property is the first element, just like a musical scale, like Sarigama Padanisa. Okay. What is the drawback of Euler's classification? Okay. Drawback. He could arrange the elements up to calcium. Okay. He could arrange the elements up to calcium. Very good. We could arrange the elements up to calcium. We could arrange the elements up to calcium. It is very, very most important. Calcium only. Okay. Write down. Students, completed, huh? Okay. Next one, Mendeleev's classification. Mendeleev's classification, okay? Mendeleev's classification. Mendeleev's classification means? Mendeleev's classification. Okay, it is very, very most important. Today we discuss about only statement. Okay, what is the Mendeleev classification? The physical and chemical properties of elements are the periodic functions of their atomic mass. This is called Mendeleev classification. Okay, the physical and chemical properties of elements. The physical and chemical properties of elements. Periodic function based on atomic mass. Okay, periodic function of the atomic mass. This is called Mendeleev's classification. It is called Mendeleev's classification. Mendeleev's classification. Mendeleev's classification. Completed up. Okay. Next one. Next important statement is Moseley's classification. Moseley's classification. Moseley's classification. Moseley's classification. Moseley's classification means the physical and chemical properties of elements or the periodic functions of the atomic numbers. This is called Moseley's classification. Okay, the physical and chemical properties of elements. The physical and chemical properties. Chemical properties of elements are the periodic functions of the atomic numbers. This is called Moseley's classification. This is called Moseley's classification. Right off. Okay, thank you. Tomorrow we will learn about remaining classifications. Okay, thank you.